But hold on, let me finish. Government is force. It's nothing but violence.
See how you point so much?
And voting is violence for the simple reason of this.
Okay.
You are electing these mythical people that think that they have the authority of you, and government is force because government makes people do things that they don't want to do, and it stops people from doing things that they do want to do, and those fucking demands are always, always backed up by police with fucking guns.
You know what?
Yes. That's it.
You know what?
Yeah.
You don't...
I made my point.
You don't respect me.
Of course
okay?
I do.
No, you don't. I don't
I give you a hug. Your feelings are hurt.
I don't know. I don't appreciate the way that you talk. You're,
yeah,
you're very.
I don't care. Seriously, don't care.
Look, I want this. I want this guy to
I
feel
love
some love.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
He needs some. He needs some.
Can I ask you a question? I assume you vote for like Ron Paul or something.
Yes.
Are you not advocating that someone gets into a position of power where he is going to demand under threat of violence money from me?
You're not
going
to vote this year.
That's a good question, and I'm willing to, contemplate the idea that, you know, that voting for the lesser, because it's always the lesser of evils, right, that is in some way, advocating for government. But I suppose in the past, you know, I've never voted... There's been very, very few people I've ever voted for that I've ever won. And if they did, it was because it was a vote for 2 out of 3, and one of them won.
Right.
In a town election. I don't agree with the system, and I have slowed my voting, and it's been a while since I voted for Ron Paul, and my views have changed since then. I'm growing and learning. I'm learning from this man. I'm learning from you and everybody around here. So I'm willing to listen to the ideas of that, you know, okay, I shouldn't vote. But at the same time, when the reality is voting does exist and politicians do exist, and if I don't vote, somebody else will vote. And even if nobody votes, somebody will still be in office until everyone's mind has changed that we don't need them. So the voting or the not voting is inconsequential of whether we believe that the government is legitimate. I will likely, at this moment, vote sometimes up until the point at which we have all decided that government is unnecessary and we can just disband it, and then I won't have to vote for that. I'll just vote for like American Idol or something like that.
Well said.
And here goes one thing that you can interject the next time James is in. Distracted, basically, you know. I mean, is it a sin or wrong or however he wants to phrase it to go into the voting booth and write it in Donald Duck or, you know, Mickey Mouse?
Great party you had here.
Mickey Mouse.
Well, I have voted for freedom.
We came to monumental.
Right. And when
point
I voted
in history
in,
here,
the keys were laid
Donald
out
Duck is good and Mickey Mouse is not when voting.
At least something's been determined.
Yeah.
I think we need to give James Cox more booze and see what happens.
That sounds dangerous. I love James.
You know what? You really got to test the limits. You know, like, you need to just keep feeding and see where it goes.
As if pressing buttons in booths actually give someone a right to indigenous.
So me not voting then will
by itself won't do anything. But you can be consistent. I think
that this well wait, if I want to be effective, so you're telling me whether I vote or not, it
sometimes
doesn't
it is, sometimes it isn't.
No, I'm saying to be consistent, you can't vote.
Okay.
Because if you go and push the button for Ron Paul, never mind that he's not gonna win. If yours was the vote that put him in office, you put a thief on a throne and said, he's allowed to rob me. Now, the fact that he robs me like this instead of like this, you could say that's an improvement, but that's not okay to advocate that I be robbed, even a little bit, even just for constitutional
reasons. Well, I disagree, because actually the fact remains that the government does exist. We've all agreed that the government does exist today and will exist tomorrow.
No, it won't.
I'm talking not in the literal tomorrow. tomorrow of the years, but tomorrow as in tomorrow, Sunday
June
or Monday.
June 26th, yeah.
Right. So my vote for Ron Paul is to lessen the negative effects of government upon me today. So my vote is for today, and you're right. It is, I'm still saying I would rather have this tyrant than that tyrant because those are the choices that are here today. And like I said, there is another choice, but today the choice is, you know, do you want less, a worse tyrant or a better tyrant? And so that's why I voted for Ron Paul. I'm not saying, I'm not saying that, okay.
Sure it is.
Well,
that's one of many choices. There are a lot of choices, and that's one choice.
Yeah,
and you can do that.
Yeah,
and you can do what he does, and I think it's a very reasonable argument. And at the same time, do things like education. You can do things like education like you do, and you can do things like build alternate institutions like the agorists do, and we can all do it together as friends.
But see, here,
and
here's why.
In a complementary way.
We
can build, no, but I'm saying we can build on each other's work.
I'm saying
we don't have to be in conflict.
I'm saying voting is always and absolutely the enemy of freedom.
So let's say he votes in Ron Paul. Ron Paul legalizes marijuana, frees 50,000 or a million or whatever nonviolent legal offenders from prison, and they turn into freedom fighters, activists with us.
To the
that builds
problem.
On us. No, but it helps.
It takes no step.
It helps.
Freedom, none.
It absolutely does.
Here's
it
why.
Helps.
Here's why. If we believe in the legitimacy of the throne, if we pretend the throne is legitimate, even if we get the greatest, nicest, most benevolent guy on the throne, we have done nothing to achieve freedom. All we did is get the nicest slave master possible. That will never achieve freedom.
Well, you're speaking in complete absolute. And that's not reality. I'm
the
sorry.
Game,
reality is not complete absolutes, and that's how you're being extremely hyperbolic about this, and that's just not reality.
No,
reality
play,
is not absolutes.
When you play the game of voting and democracy and politics, what you're doing is legitimizing the entire problem.
No,
you're not.
No, you're collectivizing me with other voters, and that's not me, because when I go to the voting... to vote, I might say this is not legitimate, and I might speak to people, and I might even tell them, you know, that I'm voting out of fear, and that I'm trying to get a better, you know, a better slave master for this time period. So I might admit to that, and I don't question you're not voting. I think that it's a, you know, you're taking the high road. You know, of course, you know that it's, and that's good, and I'm glad that you're doing that because that you feel that that's right, and I'm not trying to legitimize what I'm doing. But this is, at times, what I felt was, you know, the best thing for my immediate today, you know. And part of liberty in our lifetime is in our lifetime, and I want more liberty. And sometimes I'm willing to, I guess, sacrifice maybe a little bit of my soul for voting. But I don't know. I haven't.
It's not even
that. I'm not even sold on that yet. But
you seem to be making his point.
See, here's the thing. If you. Like, I believe, and he'll complain about this terminology, but we had that argument. We'll have it again, I'm sure. I believe that I own me and you own you. Absolutely.
Of course.
And that neither of us is a slave. Nobody can legitimately own either one of us.
Well, I am a slave, and I recognize that I'm a slave because I pay taxes. That's
not a
portion.
Rightful slave. Let me put it
I'm not a rightful slave, and I also believe that as slaves, I think this is a really important thing that, you know, as slaves, I think we have, you know, we're justified in emancipating ourselves.
Yeah, but see, that's the thing. If we accept that there is such thing as government and authority, and that's the thing, government implies authority. It implies it's legitimate because we don't call the street gang government. When we call something else government, it imbues it. It implies that the thing is legitimate somehow. That pressing buttons actually does something that's legitimate. And all that can ever do is decide who the slave master is. It is a fundamentally different step to say, I own myself no matter who wins. No matter who you vote for, no matter what you call law, no matter what you call crime, no matter what you do, I will own myself, which means I never have a reason to go do the weird political voodoo cult rituals known as democracy and legitimize your game of slave masters that say you get to pick which one of us is going to whip you.
Right. Well, I, you know, look, I I agree with that, but at the same time, we are the slaves, and so you're saying when the slave master says, you know, you actually get to vote for this guy to whip you or that guy to whip you, and, you know, this guy's got a big arm, and the other guy's got a little arm, and, you know, I'm like, look, I still am going to emancipate myself as soon as humanly possible. That's what I'm working towards, right? I'm out in the field, and I'm working, and I keep looking, I'm checking to get out. But at the same time, I don't want to be whipped as much. So when the slave master says, I can vote for my whipping boy, I'm going to vote for the lesser guy because that's my reality today on the plantation.
Yeah, but
it's an incremental step in a more positive direction.
But it isn't an incremental step towards anything.
Sure it is.
Well, like, there isn't such thing as an incremental step between your somebody else's property and you own yourself. You can have a nicer guy owning you or a meaner guy owning you, a guy with a big arm or a guy with a little arm.
Right.
Neither of them is an inch closer to you owning yourself.
Yeah, can I step in here for a second?
Sure.
I invite you to consider what you just said. You said you are a slave.
Like, right.
But you'd like to emancipate yourself.
Yes.
I take the position that I am not a slave.
Okay.
I am being treated as a slave.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I will pretend to behave as if I was a slave in certain conditions so I can maintain my ability to walk around without being chains on my leg.
Right.
But at no time do I consider myself to be a slave.
Okay. I like that. I like that point of view, and I will likely adopt something closer to that than what I'm saying. But I'm really just trying to make the point that, in fact, like you're saying, at points we act like a slave. So, you know, if it walks like a duck and talks like a duck, you know, quacks like a duck.
But if you change your mindset, right. One of the things this book is about is changing your mindset, and what all you've been talking about is legitimacy, and there's a bright line between I own myself and somebody else owns me.
Well, I know that. Look, I know I am a free man, although, you know, in my mind, I am a free man. I believe that I have, you know, am legitimate in emancipating myself from the violence. From the institutionalized violence, and I'm doing my best to figure out what the best way to do that is. And one of the ways that I've come to realize that I want to lead by example. So one of the things that I want to lead by example is by loving people. I love you, and I love you. And I think you're wonderful people, and that's why the gentleman earlier, you know, that's why I told him that I didn't want him to, you know, to speak all this violence because
right.
that he's creating his own, you create mm-hmm. your own reality with your, so I want to have a positive outlook, and mm-hmm. that's the reality. I'm creating the reality right now because there is no means to the end because in the end we all die. The means is our life. So let's
right.
enjoy and live our life as free minds and free men and love and let's
yeah.
live peace.
And I really admire that. Excuse me. I really admire that. And I'm just asking you to look to see you could be more consistent with that point of view because I really like the fact that you pick up on the language. I agree with you. I think violent imagery, we need to look at that and go, do I really want to be speaking that? And you're... I totally admired your calling him on that and going, hey, wait a minute, let's change our minds. So I invite you to look in a mirror and go, when you say I'm a slave, I'm going to vote, I'm going to do this.
Right.
It's like, well, how is that consistent with the world you want to, I mean, because I agree, we do create our own reality. And it starts up here. So I invite you to take it to the next step and go, well, let's look at this voting thing here. Am I really creating a reality
so,
that I don't want?
I guess what the reason that I struggle with the voting thing is that, you know, I understand that voting for the most part is inconsequential.
Which made it all that much easier for me to give it up.
Right. But, you know, it comes down to that some people, I want to convince people of, you know, what's good and what's better and move towards those things. It's very easy for bad people to take control of the reins of government and make things bad. And that is still the reality. And so, especially locally, if there's a chance for me to say, look, here's somebody that's a, you know, peace-loving, liberty-minded person, I would rather have that person be the one that's in charge of the money that's being stolen from me so that hopefully they can steal less rather than this other guy.
And that it can give him a space,
yeah.
a little more space in which to expand the reign of liberty.
It's like right. drinking seawater.
Yes.
Yes.
If I have,
because right. that's all we need is a little more space you know.
And it's, see, here's why to, like, I don't at all
to topple the whole thing. Look at Gorbachev. Look at when Gorbachev came in. He was a kinder, gentler, you know, Soviet. Yeah. And the thing fell apart because he was a kinder, gentler one. He couldn't do it. So what? So what? It was a step towards more liberty.
It was not a step at all towards more liberty.
No, you want all or nothing.
Because
for you, it's all or nothing.
Yeah, I own me or somebody else.
Okay, that's absolutist black and white thinking, and I'm sorry.
What, somebody owes,
that's not how the world works. Like you said, it's a dimmer switch.
To get
so he's going, all right, let's have just a little bit more light.
Yeah, but
and then maybe he'll like it all fall apart and I'll have complete light.
In this case, there is none. There is either, there's the line of how nice your master is, how hard he hits you, and then there's, you don't have a master, you own yourself. And the reason, you know, I am not at all doubting your motives or wanting to be freer and, you know, given the choice between being hit really hard and being hit lightly is a lot better. There's a reason I think going for that is a huge mistake. Okay. And I actually did, if you go to larkenrose.com on Outside the Cage, a new radio show I have, one of the things I did was explain that there's this slave master, and one day he goes out and says, now we're all in this together, and we're all working together, and you get to decide whether I'm in charge of the plantation or my brother is. And he does all these things. Their situation doesn't change at all. But the way he describes it changes. So we're going to have weekly meetings. The slaves can come and voice their opinions, and you can choose which, and gives them all this propaganda. And one of the slaves says, nothing changed. Our reality is exactly the same. The only way it changes is when the victims, the problem is not in Washington. It is when the victims stop hallucinating legitimacy to what is being done to them. And you cannot do that by voting. Playing their game cannot tear down the legitimacy of their game. Even if you won, even if Ron Paul got in, you know, people say, let's get back to the Constitution. If we got back to the Constitution, we would come right back here. We tried that. Right. Started there. Right. We got here.
Right.
The only way to get to freedom is for the victims to realize I have no master. And a nicer master is not one shred closer to I have no master than a mean master.
And if you walk into that voting
different
booth
direction,
and you press that lever, you're saying, I have a master.
No, you're not. No, you're not.
I disagree with the absolutism. You're saying that if I have... That you're saying that if I have more freedom than I have now, I'm no closer to being free than if I'm in prison.
Like, absolutely. I am. And
but that doesn't make sense. That's contradictory. Because
well,
he has a little bit more.
Spend your life in prison. I'm going to live my free
you'll
life.
You'll like it more. Yeah. It'll be more fun. It'll be more pleasant.
That's what life is about.
Yeah,
loving and living
matters.
And enjoying.
Wait,
that's what we're here to do is
that,
enjoy
I'm
life.
I'm not saying that doesn't matter. I'm saying you're no closer to being a free human being, just as if you have a sheep in a little pen and you let him go into a big pen.
Right.
They're still hostage livestock.
You have to get past the absolutism.
No.
You're lost. You're lost in ideology and absolutism. You have to get past it.
I'm not going to get past reality. You're in a cage
no.
or you're not. You have a mask.
Reality
you're
is not absolute. You yourself said it.
We're all imprisoned on this planet other than the astronauts, the lucky few astronauts who get to go to the moon. Maybe some, you know, and... You know, nobody's even going to the moon right now. So
right,
we're all imprisoned on this planet.
Because the state is sucking up all the resources.
Right.
Without a government,
we'd be on other planets. Yeah, but that's a
right.
physical limitation. It's not somebody enforcing it upon you. There's nobody
well,
saying
a
there's
jail,
a law. You're
a jail
not
is a physical limitation.
Enforced on you by other human beings.
Right.
Saying, we're going to cage you.
Right.
And if you, it's just a distinct, you know, there were really mean slave masters and there were relatively nice slave masters, as nice as you can be and still be a slave master. And on that line, none of them were any closer to being free human beings. It was just a matter of how mean is the guy who's hitting us.
In fact,
it is stepping off the line completely to say, I don't acknowledge any master. You can hit me, you can hurt me.
I disagree when you say that it's no closer. I mean, I don't.
It's more pleasant.
That's as if saying, I mean, I've met so many people that have come to the Liberty Movement because they listen to Ron Paul. And I don't worship Ron Paul. I'm not looking for Ron Paul to be president. He's not going to be. But, you know, a lot of people came to the movement because of his campaign.
Yeah.
And you know what? They started off as statists, I guess we could call them. And, Ron Paul, introduced them to some ideas, and they realized that, wait, there's a bit of consistency logic here. And some of those people would call themselves, the negative term of anarchist, which I think is a bad term to use to
for PR.
But they now are maybe, some of them are maybe your listeners and believe exactly what you believe, and some of them don't vote. So they actually moved along the line. They were very statist. Then they realized, well, wait, here's a man who makes some sense, and they moved. So you're saying that as these people moved along that line, you're saying they were no closer to freedom yet.
No.
At some point, they jumped off of that into this. You're saying like that line has nothing to do with this. You're trying to make like, oh, this is one line, and then this is a whole nother land, and one doesn't lead to the next. But that's not true. They did. It was that path that brought them then to the final conclusion.
Yeah, the path in that belief
where you are,
is closer. And I went down that. I was a conservative Republican for most of my life.
Right.
And the path to, they don't have the right to do this to me, they don't have the right to do that to me, they don't have the right to do this to me. The last step is really uncomfortable, which is they don't have the right to do anything to me. I own myself. I have no master.
Right.
That's a really hard step for people to take. That is getting closer to understanding that you own yourself.
Mm-hmm.
But living in the world under a nice master or a mean master is not any closer to being free. It's a lot more comfortable. I'm not saying it's not preferable. I'd much rather work an hour in the cotton field instead of 20.
So here's the question. If people came to the ideas of freedom through the Ron Paul campaign, and by voting for Ron Paul, all of a sudden I'm promoting statism, but in fact, I'm promoting a man who's bringing people to the ideas of freedom, which is actually moving us closer, hopefully, to true freedom.
Except you're nailing them down at the stage of still believing in a ruling class.
No, he's moving them. He's putting them in motion.
Not by voting.
Look, I'm not crucifying anybody. I'm not nailing anybody down. That's your logic. I'm kissing and hugging. That's what I'm doing, man.
No, but I mean, you're not saying, you're not saying you don't have a master. You're saying it would be better if he was. And physically, again, I'm not saying it wouldn't be a whole lot better.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody would be my slave master, I would love for it to be Ron Paul.
Right.
If I could choose my slave master, that would be a lot more comfortable.
Right.
But I don't have a slave master.
Right.
And to ever act as if you do strengthens the notion among you and everybody you talk to and everybody who sees it,
right,
that there is such thing as a legitimate ruling
class. Yeah, I don't buy it because, I mean, there have been the towns where nobody showed up to vote. And guess what? There was still a guy, the guy who was the incumbent, he was still the guy.
Yeah.
So nobody cared to vote. Cared to vote, and nobody voted. Zero votes. And guess what? Government still existed. So, again, it's back to what I said. It's in the minds. And what we're doing as far as voting and on paper, it doesn't matter because we already know that a very small percentage of people vote. Very small percentage of people know what's going on, but it's in the mind. That's what we need to change people's minds. And whether I vote for one guy or not, I don't think is, going to prevent freedom from coming about. Because, again, government will exist not because people vote or not vote, but because we've changed our minds to decide that we don't need government. I've already decided I don't need government. We don't need government. We can live without it. But in the meantime, while I'm convincing others, I may, from time to time, vote. It's been a long time since I voted. It's not something I'm running out to do. I've gotten a few of those things in the mail and just tossed them aside. I mean, I got the census worker knocking on my door, and I ignored them. I saw their papers, I saw their threats, and I just, put them in a pile. And I said, maybe I'll do something with that someday, burning or something. So it's in the mind, the voting, whether I go and vote, it's almost inconsequential. So I may decide not to vote at some point. I may take that road, but I may not. I mean, for me, I believe that, especially on a local level, I think that actually through politics, people can be convinced because some of the people that are not on board look up to the politicians, and if somebody that is, freedom-oriented can be put into politics, they now have a pedestal that others look up to, and when that person says, you down there who are looking up at me don't need me. I'm here, but you don't need me. And I'm going to tell you why I'm here, and thank you for, you know, having me here, you know, those that voted, but you don't need me. So I think that that's a possibility. So I'm not going to completely discount voting. I mean, it doesn't, I don't feel that by my vote for whoever is legitimizing the violence against you. And I'm sorry that you take it that way.
Well, you know, I'm not taking offense to it. You know, I get that you would rather it be none and you want this because you think it's an improvement.
Right.
And physically and on practical terms, like I said, it would be an improvement if the slave master was nicer.
Right.
But I'm saying that, and I'm so tempted to say the whole freaking book, but my family's trying to drag me away.
Okay.
It's not we need to do away with government. It's we need to understand that there never was such a thing. It never had authority. It cannot be legitimate. It never has been. When the victims of it accept that and act accordingly, we'll look back on the days when we voted and petitioned the king, and please will you do this, as why the heck did we do that? In the town where nobody voted, that's not the solution.
Right.
In the town where nobody votes and nobody accepts the authority of that government, the government's done.
Right.
If everybody says you can't have our money, you can't have our obedience, goodbye, we don't even pay attention to you,
right,
that's when they become free, when they understand that they never had a right for
it. I agree 100%. And again, it just matters that they have that mindset. The voting is inconsequential at that point.
Yeah.
Because as soon as the mindset is there, the voting is inconsequential. And,
yeah.
and I agree.
Oh, good.
Well, that's it. Yay!
Yay! Well, I'm getting out of here.